Hello everybody, Wade McNutt here, pianomeditation.com. Today's song is I Will Rise by Chris Tomlin. And just the words of this song, Jesus has overcome and the grave is overwhelmed. Lord, let us pray the words of this and give glory to you during this lesson. If you're using cheat sheets, we're going to be in the key of G today. Seems like Chris Tomlin plays in G a lot. It's a great key on the guitar, and also a great key on the piano. Our chords we'll be using are E minor, C, D, G, and then we will have a couple slash chords that we will talk about. Again, cheat sheets, there's a little link there if you want to see more about them. Great way to learn how to play chord piano. Here we go. Starting off at the top of the song, we're going to play an E minor, and as we go, I'm going to play like this with the hands so you can see the chords at the beginning. Don't play like this, you want your hands to be outstretched, nice little curve as you play the piano. So for this E minor, a regular E minor will be these three notes, E, G, B. We're going to invert it, and all that means is you put the notes in a different order. So instead of the B being here, we're going to move it down here. That's how we're going to play the E minor. So if you hear me say inversion, that's what's happening. We're just moving those notes in a different place. And that way we can play everything close together and it sounds more professional. All right, so starting off in E minor. There's a peace I've come to know. To a C. And by the way, in the bass, you can play just octaves. You can put this note here in the middle one that's called a fifth. Don't worry what that means. So going to the C, we're going to just play a fifth, C and the G here, and then C, E, G in its root position, so no inversion there. Though my heart, we changed to G, we got an inversion of G here, G, D, and B, and I'm going to play G, D, G in the bass. Heart and flesh may fail. D chord, inversion of a D chord, A, D, F sharp, D's in the bass, and you can put this note if you want to. The thing you got to be careful of is once you get lower on the piano, it can start to sound muddy. So once it does, just go to the bass notes. Okay? May fail. E minor. There's an anchor for my soul. Well, that time on the C, I just played these bass notes. So you have options. You can play the double C's. You can come over here. You can play C and G. Right into a G chord. I can say it is well. Then to our pre-chorus, to a G chord. Jesus has overcome. And right there we will go to a D over F sharp, and on the music you would see a D slash F sharp, and all that means is the first part D, play your D chord, the F sharp is only talking to the bass player or the bass note, and so we'll play an F sharp here in the bass. It's overcome to an E minor, and the grave is overwhelmed. C chord. Now we're gonna do another slash. For the victory, G over B. So I'm going to play B in the bass, G chord here. And you can even play this G as part of the bass if you want to. But make sure that B is the lowest for your G over B. The victory is won. Now we're going to have a D sus. So our regular D chord is here. For the sus, we always move the middle note, or the note right above your D, your root, up. That'll give you a sus chord. In root position, it looks like this. Regular chord, sus chord. Okay. And it'll say sus or sus 4 to do that. If it said sus 2, you would move down. So, sus chord. Victory is won. Resolve to the D chord. Is risen, E minor, from the dead C chord. And now to our chorus, G. I will rise when he calls my name. D chord, E minor. No more sorrow, C chord. No more pain, G, D. I will rise on eagle's wings, E minor. For my God, fall on sea, my knees. I will rise, G, to a C. Will rise, and then a G over D. G slash D in the bass to a D chord. Okay, play through verse 2 and call it out. I'm going to play with the regular hands here. There's a day that's dawning near. That was an E minor C. Then we'll do G D. When the darkness breaks to light, E minor C. And the shadow. Back to the pre-chorus and the chorus. Let's look at the bridge. We'll start off on a C chord. And I hear the voice. And on voice, we're going to land on a C chord. And you can even make it, they would call it a C2 chord. So you can add this two note in there. Voice of many, G chord. C, G, D, and we'll do that C2 again. Worthy is the Lamb. C, G, D. Hear the cry of every longing heart. Same thing again. Worthy is the Lamb. And there you go. Those are all the chords to I Will Rise. Let's talk real quick about going pro and all those who have the cheat sheets. Again, you can go look on the website, pianomeditation.com, at the store, and check those out. Learn how to play chord piano and learn how to do a little improv, think in numbers. So that's what we're going to talk about now. Pentatonic scale for the key of G. These five notes, and we can work these in different shapes, such as this. Rock and roll fingers go up to that right here on that, go up here, or you can go down on this bottom one. So you keep the pinky down the whole time. What you're going to do with these, get comfortable with it. And then you can use them for fills or improvisation. So, for example, the beginning of the song. There's a peace I've come to know. My heart and flesh may fail. So you use that in between when you're singing to add to the song. And if you're playing in a band situation, one instrument will be doing this, specifying on maybe verse 1, the piano is going to do fills, verse 2, guitar. So that just fills up the song and gives it that more professional sound. So work on that with your pentatonic scale. That'll help you fill some things up. Talk in Nashville numbers real quick. If you're using the cheat sheet, you'll see the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 at the bottom of the page. 1, 4, 5 don't have a dash. That means they're major. 2, 3, and 6 are minor. And 7 is diminished. If you've watched some of the videos, we've been going over this. And just, you see, this is your G scale. You see the chords that follow that. G, A, B, C, D, E, F. And any key's gonna follow that diatonically, Don't worry about that word, that just means chords in the key. So this way we can transpose the song. So let's go to the chorus. We'll do pre-chorus, be a great example here. G, if you look at your number, G is a 1. Then we have a D over F sharp. So a D is a 5 and F sharp is a 7. So we call that a 5/7. And then E minor is a 6 minor. So 1, 5 over 7, 6 minor. So let's go to another page of the cheat sheet. So let's say we wanted to play this in D instead of G. Well, what is our 1 chord? If you see that on the key of D on page 2, D chord is a 1 chord. 5 over 7 would be an A over C sharp. And then our 6 minor is B minor. So now, it's maybe really high when I try to sing it. I'll sing it low. Jesus has overcome. And the grave is so. And all of a sudden we're in a new key. So start to think of numbers, and that will help you get to the next level. Check out the Facebook page. There's a link at the bottom of this video. Also, check out Cheat Sheets. They will help you a lot. And the website, pianomeditation.com. God bless y'all. We will see you later. Adios!